What's going on, guys? Welcome to Yoda Expedition. I'm Corey. Today we're going to be taking a look at a few different options for leveling kits for the third gen Tundra. We have four different options here: AFE, Icon, Superlift, and Fabtech. They all claim to be leveling kits, but they all measure something different. So today we're going to find out which one really makes your Tundra level. So we did the measuring. On the front, we got 22 3/4. On the rear, we got 25 3/8. So doing the math, we need about 2 5/8 of lift in the front to make it pretty much level with the rear. So let's go ahead and see what each one of these claims to lift, and then we'll start from there. Starting with AFE over here, it measures 1.495, so essentially 1.5 inches thick, and they claim it lifts 1 7/8. So what it measures to what they claim it lifts is a difference of 3/8 inch. Next up, we have Icon here. This is the tallest one. This measures 1.7 inches and it claims to lift 2.5 inches. So that's a difference of 0.08, just a little bit more than 3/4 inch. Then we have Superlift. This measures 1.285 inches and it claims to measure 2 inches. So we have a difference of 0.715 inches, almost 3/4 inch between what it measures and what they claim it lifts. Last, we have AFE. This only measures 1 inch and it claims to be lifting your Tundra at 1.5 inches. So that's a difference of 0.5 inch. This is the thinnest of all of the leveling kits that we have here. So based on the math that we did, we need 2 5/8 of lift. The Icon claims 2.5 inches. So on paper, this would be the first one that we should start with. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get the Tundra up in the air. We'll get started on ripping the suspension apart and start installing these. So the first thing you need to do is drop down the active arrow here on the front of the Tundra. In order to do that, just put it in accessory mode and hold up on your right steering wheel stock for a couple seconds and you'll hear it drop down. Now that you did that, you can go ahead and remove the bolts for the front sway bar. In order to get the sway bar all the way off, we're gonna have to take off this carpeted skid plate or whatever you wanna call it. So there's 4 12 millimeter bolts holding this on. Now with your sway bar out of the way, we need to loosen these nuts here on the lower control arm. These bolts are adjustable for when you're doing your alignment. So I have a paint marker here. I'm going to mark it into position that it is currently in. So when I go to put it back together, if it did move, I could put it back to that spot. Regardless, you should be getting an alignment done after you do any sort of suspension modifications. But I would just get it back to where it was. So when you drive it to the shop to get it aligned, it's close to where it was. Bing. So these are a 24 millimeter. We're gonna go ahead and crack these loose. So we got that loose enough that I can turn it by hand. That should be good enough. Go ahead and do the other side as well. Next up, we'll take out the bolt that's going through the bottom of your shock. It's gonna be a 22 millimeter. See ya. Next up, we're gonna take the two bolts off here, holding the lower ball joint on. Once we get these two out, we can swing the whole lower control arm down and then take the nuts on the top, holding the strut on, and we can pull that out. These are gonna be a 22 as well. So with the lower control arm swung out of the way, we got plenty of room down here to pull out the shock assembly. So we'll just go ahead and take the four nuts off on the top that is holding it in and pull that right out. So with the strut assembly out on the table and looking at the four leveling kits that we have here, the AFE and the Icon are the two that you don't have to do any modifications to your strut assembly to make them fit. They'll simply slide right on, you bolt them down, and then you can put this right back into your truck. The Superlift and the Fabtech, since they are thinner, you need to trim down your studs on the top of your top hat here. You have to make the studded section or the threaded section about a half inch long in order to make these work. So if cutting these studs off is something that you don't want to have to do, then AFE and Icon are going to be your two options here. So the spacer is only going to fit onto the strut one way. If you look at the top of your top hat, there is a section that says out. You want to be making sure that you are putting the whole assembly back in the way that you took it out of the truck. So we can go ahead and slide this on and get all of these nuts started. We're gonna be using the OEM nuts here. These are gonna be torqued down to 40 foot-pounds, both here and the new nuts that are supplied from Icon. All right, now we can put this back in, making sure it's in the right orientation. Get these nuts started up in the top. So included with your Icon leveling kit is going to be these spacers for your bump stops. Icon's the only kit that includes this, which is nice. Since you are moving the whole range of your suspension down, you should also move the bump stop down. If you don't, you take chance of bottoming out your shock, blowing the seals out, and then you're gonna have to replace your strut. So we're gonna go ahead and get those installed as well. So right here's your factory bump stop. Either use like a big adjustable wrench or some channel locks here. We're gonna get this thing taken off. So we're gonna take the factory bump stop and we're gonna take the spacer from Icon. We're gonna thread those together. And then we're going to take the new stud that is provided by Icon and some blue Loctite. We're gonna thread that in there, tighten it down, and then get it reinstalled on the Tundra. So with the bump stop done, we can go ahead and grab our lower control arm. We can swing this up and get the bottom of the shock back in place. We can get that bolt in. So we got that bolt in for the lower shock. We're not gonna torque that down just yet. We're gonna wait until the wheels are back on the ground and the suspension is in its normal operating position. Any sort of bushing like that, you wanna torque in the normal operating position. If I was to torque that down now and then finish the truck and put it on the ground, those bushings would be twisting and it's not going to last as long. So we're gonna wait to torque that down. All right, so the lower control arm bolts are a bit difficult to get started because the height of that spacer is pretty big. So you have to jack up the lower control arm a decent amount so that you can get these bolts started. In fact, we kept jacking it up to the point where the lift was coming, or the truck was coming off the lift, and we really didn't like that. So we let the truck down at least until the back tires were touching the ground. I got myself a big crowbar here and a piece of wood just for extra leverage. And I put that in the spring and on the upper control arm. That way I could push down this whole assembly in order to get the one bolt started. So I got one bolt started. I'm gonna tighten that down just a little bit, enough so that I can easily get this one started. And then I'm just gonna go back and forth and get those evenly tightened up. So this side's pretty much done, other than tightening the bolt on the bottom of the shock and tightening the bolts for the lower control arm, which I said we're gonna do once the truck's back on the ground. We also have the sway bar. But I'm gonna go ahead and do everything I just did on the other side and get that done. Driver's side's done, wheels are back on, truck's on the ground. I am just going and torquing the lower control arm bolts and the lower shock bolts. I'm gonna get those torqued while it's on the ground, put it back up in the air, get the sway bar back on, and then we can go out, take this thing for a quick test drive, get the suspension moving so it settles a little bit, and then we can do a measurement and see where it sits compared to the rear. Know how the ride quality was before we put these on. I'll have to have Andrew drive it and give us like a true reaction, but it seems really bouncy. So just driving down the road and back, hitting some of the bumps, I can definitely say that it feels pretty stiff because of that spacer being so thick and having to compress everything to get it all bolted up. Definitely stiffened up the ride. And as of right now, it's sitting higher in the front than it is in the rear. So if it doesn't settle to be more level with the rear, then we might have to pull this off, go with one of them smaller kits, which in turn is gonna make it ride a little bit better because it's not gonna be compressing everything so much to get it to fit, and hopefully level it too. All right, so we just took it for a test drive and it's still sitting way higher in the front than it is in the rear, and it honestly rides really stiff. So the front before measured 22 3/4. So I'm gonna go ahead and measure this again and see how much of a difference we have. So we're at pretty much 26 1/2. That's a lot. Let me do the math. We were at 22 3/4, we're now at 26 1/2. That's way more than 2 1/2 inches, which Icon says is what it lifts it. So 3 3/4 inches is what it's lifted. Let me measure the rear again. Our measurements might be off a little bit because of the floor, but I mean, the floor is pretty flat. It's not gonna be out, the floor's not gonna be out over an inch. So this side, or the rear, about 25 1/4. I think it was 25 1/2 before. 25 3/8 to 25 1/4. So we only changed there by 1/8 of an inch. So we were looking for 2 5/8 of lift to get it to be level with the rear. Icon said 2 1/2. We ended up getting 3 3/4. So now the front is 1 1/4 taller than the rear. So tomorrow I'm probably gonna pull the Icon leveling kit off and then go with one of these other three options. Honestly, the 35s fit stock, so I might put these FabTechs on, which claims to be 1 1/2 lift. And I think, based on what we're seeing here, if I put these on, I think we'll be pretty good as far as levelness and clearing the 35s without rubbing anything. So we'll see. So it's the next day, got the Tundra back on the lift. I'm gonna go ahead and get the Icon leveling kit taken off, and then I'm going to install the FabTech leveling kit. Everything's gonna be pretty much the same exact install, except once we go to put this on the strut assembly, we have to shorten those studs down. So I'll show you how to do that when I get there. All right, we got the strut assembly back out. We got the Icon off. Now, in order to get these FabTech ones to fit on, we need to cut these studs here on the factory strut assembly. So we're going to measure 1/2 inch, mark all 4 of these studs, and we'll get them cut off with either an angle grinder or Dremel, whatever you have at home. So we got those studs all trimmed up, so now the new kit will actually fit on, and you can get those threaded on. I'm going to clean up that edge where I cut it so the threads start a little bit easier, and then we'll get this installed. FabTech kit comes with some red Loctite. We're going to be putting that on the factory studs here that we just cut. So getting all of these nuts started is a little bit tricky. So best thing I found to do is stand it up, lift each corner to get the nut inside there like so. And now applying pressure down, we can get the nuts started on each corner. FabTech's gonna provide you nuts to use in here. So make sure you're using the right ones. Thank you. The lower ball joint bolts are much easier to get started now because you don't have such a huge gap that you have to get together in order to get the thread started. Well, right away it feels better. It's not so bouncy. You actually have some shock, not just all spring. Definitely feels better than the Icons did. Since that spacer is the thinnest one out of all of them that we were gonna test, it's probably closest to OEM ride quality out of all of them, so. Let's see how this thing looks from the outside. So we got the FabTech leveling kit installed. We just took it for a test drive. The front suspension almost feels OEM, so that's definitely a plus. And it looks to be pretty much level. If anything, the front is out by maybe a quarter inch. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna pull it inside now. We're gonna do another measurement and we're gonna see what we get. And then after that, we're gonna put the 35s on here and call it a day. So before we're at 22 3/4, we are now at 25 1/4. We're now at 25 1/4 in the front, and before the rear measured 25 3/8. So we're only off by 1/8 inch. So that's pretty good to me. So with that being said, the FabTech is probably the way to go if you're looking to level your Tundra. I don't know where everyone's getting their numbers, but when you actually put it to the test and see how much it's actually lifting it, the numbers that you measure in real life versus what they say it's gonna lift it are completely different. So FabTech is gonna be the way to go if you're just looking to level the front of your truck. So I'm gonna get the Tundra back on the lift. We're gonna get these stock wheels and tires off, and we're gonna get these new 35s and Method wheels on there and see how it looks. All right guys, that's a wrap. We got the FabTech leveling kit on there now with the 35s, and it looks almost perfectly level. Rides pretty good as well. So if I had to make a suggestion on which leveling kit to get, it would be the FabTech. If you're gonna go with one of the other ones that we had earlier in the video, I would probably pair that up with something in the rear as well. Otherwise, it's just gonna be way off and not sitting level. So if you wanna grab this leveling kit or any of the other ones, wheels, tires, whatever it is for your third gen Tundra, you can head over to yodaexpedition.com or click the link down in the description. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one.